Hey guys, today I'm going to show you around the system I put together for my dual battery setup on my Westfalia. I built this system because some of the other kits on the market did not assess my needs. They generally use much smaller batteries, I think 50 amp hour, and now I think I've got at least 150 amp hours using a stock size battery that fits under the seat. I also wanted to be able to jump start off the auxiliary battery, which I've now made possible, which is really nice if you're in a situation where for some reason the van battery is dead and it won't start the engine. This allows you to flip a switch and basically start the engine, which is really nice. It also allows, because it's wired directly, not directly, but it uses a much higher gauge wire than those kits. It goes to a solenoid and then to the main battery. Well, when the alternator is on, or when the alternator is charging the main battery, it's also charging the auxiliary battery. And that allows it to charge up that battery much faster than those kits allowed, because they went through the stock wiring where the fridge went through. And so I'll show you guys around the system, hopefully give some of you building your own kits an idea of what I did here. And I've had it installed a couple months now, and I'm really happy with it. Hopefully in the future sometime soon, I'll throw a solar panel on the roof rack and hook that into the system and hopefully have indefinite power when I'm camping. Here's just a little diagram I drew up to explain the functionality of the system. Originally, you're just going to have the main battery under the passenger seat. And then that would go to say you're going to have one wire basically going off to the starter. And then you have the rest for your van stuff going to your fuse box or whatever up front. In my system, you're basically going to, well, we'll get to this later, but that starter wire stays. Then you have this normally open solenoid, or normally closed solenoid, sorry, that when the, engine is on, or the alternator's on, it closes this gap here. And that's going to allow it to charge, the alternator to charge both batteries. You can see the starter, but also the alternator goes through here. It's going to link these together and charge both batteries at the same time. Now, that solenoid opens up when it gets signal from the alternator. So whenever the engine's off, this is open. Now, I also installed a switch to that signal wire, so I'll give it 12 volts whenever I want, and I can manually close this and jump start, which is really nice. Because if you're in the middle of nowhere and you have no one to jump start you, you can always jump start yourself. Now, what else I've got going on here is I've got the auxiliary battery under the driver's seat. This, you're going to bypass where this goes to the main fuse box, because if you want to run the stereo or anything else like the camper lights and everything, they all go to this main fuse box from the van. But you're basically going to splice that wire, and we're just going to forget about this. And now that wire is going to go to the auxiliary battery. So we're just changing where that fuse box goes for certain things, such as the radio and the camper lights and the door lights. And I think that's about it. Maybe like USB charging up front if you have that. So that's the original fuse box that we splice in there. And I'll throw in a wiring diagram that I found online that worked really well and showed you where to splice. Then you have the auxiliary battery, and this is a new fuse box that I installed. This is the aux fuse box. This allows me to hook up anything I want at any point in time. This gives me a 12 volt source of power, fuse power. Now, what's nice about that is I have my diesel heater hooked up to one of these fuses, like a USB charging station hooked up to one of those fuses. I also have a rear light hooked up, so I can hook up a whole bunch of auxiliary things if I want to, without touching the van's original fuses. Now, what I also have in this system, because the van didn't come with any way to charge the battery when you plugged it in. So originally, if you plugged it into the exterior 110 port, it would not charge the battery at all, like RVs usually do. So what I've done is installed a ProSport 12 battery charger. It actually has two separate leads, so it monitors each battery individually. So I've just got this grounded to a main ground, because the grounds are all the same. And then I've got one wire going to basically the positive lead of the main battery, and one wire going to the auxiliary lead, to the positive lead of the auxiliary battery. That allows this to monitor each battery when we're plugged in. It also charges and maintains them when it's in the garage or in storage, which is really nice when you're not driving it. You can also use a generator or whatever to plug in the van, and it'll also charge the batteries. So there's lots of options. Now, when you put this, I have this installed under the sink, and I'll show you guys that in a minute. But there is actually a 110 plug under the sink where the fridge connects, an extra one, which makes this really convenient and easy to install. Now, this is my jump start switch, so that'll link the batteries manually. And I think that's it. I think we can start showing you around the system. So now under the sink here, you'll see I have, that is the dual battery charger. Here is the auxiliary fuse box. And you can see the things I have installed on it. And here is where that is where the charger connects. So there's an extra port from the factory there. Then we follow that up. I've got a wiring loom coming up through the back. There, coming all the way up. And then here I installed this switch panel. This switch panel allows me to add extra things onto these switches. I do not have them assigned for anything right now. I just put them there for future use. This one, however, is connected so that I can, this is the basically the emergency start. So when that switch is on, that links both batteries, and you can hear the solenoid click and connect both batteries. So if I ever needed to jump start in an emergency, that's what I would use. All right, so under here, this is the passenger seat stock battery location. We've just got a stock battery in there. And the only exception, I'm not going to pull this cover off, because it's kind of a pain to get behind there and pull those screws out. But the only difference from stock is that this has an extra battery, an extra wire. And it gets a 2-gauge wire running underneath the van, going all the way over to this battery compartment. So under the driver's seat from the factory, you actually have an extra storage compartment under here that is the same size as the battery compartment on the passenger side. So that allows you to install a full-size battery
or almost full size. I think this is a 40R, and it's just perfectly sized. As you can see, the fridge relay, it fits there with the wiring on the side as well. And what I've also, I mean, you guys can't see this, but that solenoid is back there. One positive lead going here, one positive lead going to the other battery, the main battery. What I also have under there is, I'll throw in a picture that I took while I was putting this together, but I have a slim subwoofer under the storage compartment of the seat there. It required some cutting of the welds and removing the plate and then bolting the plate back down. Wasn't easy, but it's worth it. Subwoofer works well, and it's nice having the battery right here so you can wire it to that. Then I have the rest of the wiring running under the carpet. So like the fuse box wiring and everything that I was talking about earlier, that's all going under, plus my subwoofer wires where the stock wires went. And it works pretty well. So I've got that wiring goes to the fuse box and some of that goes to the charger there. It's a fairly simple system, just took a bit of time to install. And those wires, like that red wire comes through, let me see. That red wire goes through the floor there, that main 2-gauge wire. And that comes back, that goes under the van, zip tie, and then it goes back under here, and you can see that red wire. It's on this side. I didn't have to drill a hole. It actually just goes up the battery vent there. Kind of hard to see, but once you get in there, you can see what I'm talking about. So this, guys, is just a switch panel I picked up off Amazon. I'm still working on making some sort of backing or something to close that off. But it came with the wiring to wire all this. I just had to modify it a little bit. And then I also installed an LED in the corner so that you can tell when the batteries are linked or not. Then that comes down. Those switches feed these extra wires here. So I've got a couple extra wires that I can wire whatever I want to them. Maybe lights in the future, or extra accessories. And then I've got such as my diesel heater wiring running back. And I've also got the, I have a 12-volt charging setup back here that's wired to a separate fuse. So if we come back, also picked up this, which has a total of 4 USB ports and a 12 volt port. It's really nice having this by the bottom bed here, as you can charge your phone at night and leave it right here on the table. Also stock, the van does not allow you to turn on the radio without turning on the ignition. So instead of installing a normal toggle switch, I came up with the creative idea of using the stock heater switch. The previous owner had that removed at some point, so it's just the switch that's left. So what I did is, when you put it on the number one position, it fires up the radio without turning on the ignition and burning up your coil. And that works really well too. I'm happy with that. So whenever I'm parked, I can just flip that switch and listen to the radio. Simple, but you know, it works well and it makes a difference. So now I've got the van running. You can see that the batteries are combined. The alternator is charging both batteries. And pretty much whenever the engine's on, it always does that. It's really nice, keeps your auxiliary battery always charged up. So it's a simple system, but it works well. I've been very happy with it. The next step is to install a solar panel system. All I would need is a charger and a solar panel and figure out where to mount that. A charge controller. But yeah, in the future I'll end up adding probably a inverter of some sort, maybe on the exterior here or in the cabinet somewhere. I'm also at some point want to build a Arduino based system here to replace the battery and the water indicator. You can see they don't always work, and the fridge thing. So that might be a future video. If anybody was wondering, this is what I've used to secure the battery charger and the fuse box and everything else. It's really solid stuff. I'd highly recommend it. And it also means you don't have to drill any holes in your van to do this, except for the battery cables going out. But you don't have to drill into the cabinets anywhere or screw anything in, which is really nice.
If you guys have any questions on how I put this system together, don't hesitate to comment and ask. I'll try to throw in as many of the parts as I bought in the description as I can. And I'll also try to throw in the wiring diagrams that I used. But other than that, I'd say tackle it. It's a great project. Probably took me about a week to finish and find all the parts and order all the parts and everything like that. But I've been super happy with it. It definitely expands your exploration opportunities because you're not constantly worried about running out of juice or draining your battery down. So yeah, thanks for watching and see you guys later.